at Airventure Oshkosh, we've discovered an airplane we hadn't seen before. This is the Panther, and it is from a company that I don't know before, and a gentleman that I hadn't met before, but Dan, I'm Dan, so Dan Johnson meets Dan Weseman.
Hi.
And your company is Sport Performance Aviation.
Yes.
And we want to ask you about what it is we're looking at here. And you understand, Dan, that we're kind of a light sport and light aircraft web video outlet, so it looked like this was something that meets our needs.
Certainly.
Yep. Tell us a little bit about it.
The Panther is a single-seat sport aircraft. It's capable of mild aerobatics, you know, like an RV4 you would do. Through maybe sportsmen in IAC competition. This particular model has a converted Corvair engine of about 100 horsepower in.
Okay.
Our company for years has been providing bearings and crankshafts and various aviation specific parts for this engine.
I see. Okay, so you already knew the engine then?
We knew the engine. I built the Sonics, the second Sonics to fly with the Corvair and develop that firewall for it. We sell those parts, have a Fisher Celebrity biplane as our low and slow test bed. And now we have the Panther with this also. So
it's a very striking aircraft. Give us a few of the numbers about it: weight, span, length, and some performance information.
Okay, this is the LSA version. It has a 23.5 foot wingspan, about 93 square feet of wing area. It meets the LSA stall speed. With the correct prop, it meets LSA and logbook documentation meets the cruise speed. It is all 6061 T6 aluminum construction.
Yeah, it looks like the entire airplane is aluminum. Though.
All aluminum, blind rivets.
Including all the control surfaces.
Yep, everything. It's all blind rivets. The interesting feature is that the forward fuselage from the seat back to the firewall is welded 4130 square tubing.
Okay.
The skins attach much like a Titan 51 Mustang with blind rivets. It comes complete, welded. Your wing pins are already reamed when you get it, so you know you don't have to drill any holes. The landing gears bolt right in. That's completely finished and powder coated in the kits. The wings do fold.
They do fold. Okay.
The wings fold. You can pull four pins.
Kind of come like this and
along. It slides out on a tube. Yeah, it has wing tanks, but there's a quick disconnect on the fuel line. Slide them out, pop the fuel line, pull the wing back. It cradles. It came here in that trailer.
Okay.
We have flown it here. We flew it over at Broadhead. We've flown magazine shoots and stuff. So it takes about 5 minutes, you know, folded to flying.
The control linkages, are they
automatic,
just brought up again?
Yeah, you don't have to disconnect anything except for the two fuel lines. If you had landing lights or something, a quick plug on those. But another interesting feature.
Can it be done by one person?
One person, yeah.
Okay.
You have to hold one end. You have to be able to hold with a full tank. We just folded them. There's about 9 gallons of fuel in there. You've got to be able to support about 25 pounds, 30 pounds of weight. You can cut little handholds in the wingtips if it's too wide to grab.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So Rachel has folded the wings herself. She's not a big girl, but she can do it. And another interesting feature besides the wing fold is that both the seat and the rudder pedals are fully adjustable. 8 inches of adjustment in the seat. So it's made for big
guys.
You
can fit a lot of different sized people
from
in there.
If you bolt the rudder pedals in where we have, you can also physically bolt them in different positions for your adjustment range. And where we have them set right in the middle, you can fly from 5.5 to about 6.4.
Okay.
You know, just by adjusting the seat and rudder pedals. And it's a very quick, you know, two pull pins, put it back in a new position. And the rudder pedals you just do with a little selector next to your when you're sitting in the seat next to your thigh.
Okay. So, what are you using for power up front?
This is the 100 horse Corvair like we talked about.
Okay.
This works really well. Gives 1,500 feet a minute or so climb rate at 100 miles an hour.
Wow.
Lifts off at about 60. So the takeoff roll is really short. The SenseThink prop is really provides good low end thrust. It's a little longer prop than like we fly on a KR2 or a Sonic. So it gives good thrust for aerobatics or short grass strips. Really good climb. You can cruise right at the LSA limit, burning in the 4.5 to 5 gallon. An hour range.
So I was going to ask you about fuel efficiency. That's quite good then.
It has what we call dash capability. If you want to run the engine up to its maximum red line with the propeller, not the cruise red line or the maximum continuous power, if you want to run it up, it has dash capability up to 100 and about 75 miles an hour. And if you just go wide open at like 8,000 feet or whatever, you could run in the 175 true range.
So but at max continuous, you're staying within the LSA parameters?
With the max continuous with this oil cooler and all the setups, you know, and it was set to push the limits of the LSA, and that's, I make no mistakes about it. It does pushed all the limits, but that's what it was designed to do. So we've met
what
all the numbers.
What building times are we looking at for the airplane?
Building times, you can do it strictly from plans with a few components like that welded structure or from a kit. From a kit, the firewall aft, a novice guy, I'd say 500 hours. All the parts are formed, drilled. It's not 100% match tooled. I'd say it's about 75%. The structure's
meaning the holes are already drilled, and all you got to do is line them up and get your rivets in place.
Yeah, all the skins have the holes. All the control surfaces are folded. Every rib's formed. You can cleco a rib right to a spar. The spars come fully assembled. You just have to, when you get them out of the box, they're bolted together, and you just ream the holes out that don't have bolts, deburr, rivet it. You can get a quick build spar that's already riveted, but when you get it, it's already assembled in the order it goes in. All the parts are cut.
Based on what I hear you saying, are you planning to sell in the experimental amateur build?
Experimental amateur build, either plans or, you know, from a kit.
And meeting the LSA parameters, it means it's not an LSA necessarily, but it's a something that a sport pilot can operate then with a sport pilot certificate.
We actually have the second version, which is with the clipped wing and the aileron moves in with engines from the 100 horse, you know, Continental, UL, Jabiru, and small Lycoming and Corvair, all the way up to the 160 horse 0320, or one of the big ULs. You know, they have a nice line that has some bigger, lighter weight engines.
Right, they got some.
So that would be like an RV3. That's not LSA. It just doesn't meet the stall speed.
Then you'd have to have a private in the medical.
Right. But this airplane does, you know, it's only about 15 miles an hour slower in cruise than in what we goofing around flying than like 180 horse RV4 if you're running the engine, you know, intermittently. And so for 140 mile an hour cruise at low fuel burn or goofing around with your friends, I think it strikes a good balance. You know?
Seems like it to me.
How many of these are actually out flying?
This is the first one. We flew it one day before Sun and Fun this year. Right now, I think it has about 60 hours on the hob. We flew it 42 hours with a really intense test program. I had myself and another test pilot flying it. That's all documented on the web.
The FAA requirements for that.
The FAA, but also we had to fly a real test program.
Sure,
we've done everything from just about every maneuver. We've spun and stalled it and things with the flaps and clean and done a really good test program. And
a lot of flying to get all that done.
It was 40 hours and 40 days. And then we flew a little more. Now we're not really done test flying. We'll always be test flying. It's the prototype. There's lots of neat things we want to test. There's, you know, different engines to put on it and test fly with. And we plan on offering a wide range of engines because that's the biggest area. Versatility is, it's actually in our little slogan, value, versatility, integrity. We want people to have options. We want to have a version.
Well, that's the beauty of experimental amateur build too. You can do all those things.
Yeah, we want to have a version where you can have another canopy you set on that's open cockpit. I don't know why you'd want to do it, but people ask, so why not?
Why not?
It's experimental.
Good for you.
We're not going to be really hard edged unless it's a safety issue.
An airplane, how soon could they be before they get?
We have delivered in our selling tail kits. We're taking deposits on production spots for the kits, and it's not like a pie in the sky thing. We're actively making parts, taking orders. So we have documentation we're still working on, and we intend to, you know, follow it and be proactive, make it better and better as we go. We are just starting.
Got any estimate on time when the first delivery of a full kit would happen?
A full kit, let's say December, January.
Okay.
If you just called up and said, I wanted that, if you did it then, there would probably be another lead time because we've had a lot of interest.
You had a good response to it? Okay. So we normally don't do dates and we rarely do photo prices here because these videos on YouTube and elsewhere last a long time.
Sure.
So we'll caution that by saying this is AirVenture 2013. You're talking late in this year, very early in 2014 when these full kits are available. We don't need any specifics, but get us in the ballpark of price.
The ballpark, the price, firewall aft, because we have all those options. Firewall aft, without the wheels and brakes, is because there's options there also, it's $11,500. That is the price.
Okay,
and you can go to our website.
What could somebody get it in the air for, would you say, with everything they got to do?
At the low end, you could build one. Let's talk kit, because I think most people are.
Yeah.
Low end of kit, you could fly one for $25,000, and you could probably build one that was with the most expensive UL engine and autopilot and stuff for $40,000.
Okay. So very modest price then, basically.
If you wanted to build your own engine.
500 hours, that's it.
That's firewall aft. Now, I don't know how long it's going to take you to paint it or wire it.
Sure.
I wired this one in 35 hours. That's a huge span, though. I don't know. But the airframe, we're really confident saying under 500 hours from our kit for anybody. Tony Spicer has built four different airplanes, could probably build it in 350 hours. We built the whole airplane you see flying here, myself, my wife, and my neighbor, working full, all of us with full-time jobs. We built it in 9 months. So,
is that right? Okay. Well, that gives a pretty good parameter on that then. Okay, well, we've asked you a lot. You've given us a lot of information. People always want to know more, and they need a way to contact you. We'll put it on the screen, but give us your web address.
The web address is www.flywithsba.com, and then it has all our products. Just click on the one you want to, you're interested in, and feel free to contact us with any questions.
Excellent. Dan Johnson talking to Dan Weseman today.
Dan Weseman, yep.
I think I got it right.
Yeah,
pretty close anyhow. You can find lots more about all kinds of light aircraft on bydanjohnson.com or bydanjohnson.com. Thanks a lot for joining us here today.